Welcome back. You would learn about equivalent force systems in this video. Two force systems acting on a body are considered equivalent if the following conditions are satisfied. The first condition is that the vectorial sum of all the forces under system 1 is equal to the vectorial sum of all the forces under system 2, and moment of all the forces about any arbitrary point O under system 1 is equal to the moment of all the forces about the same point under system 2. The replacement of one system with an equivalent system is often used to help simplify or solve mechanics problems. So let us take up a problem and understand how a force system is simplified. Here in this problem, a beam is subjected to several forces and a couple, and we are required to find a force couple system at point A of the beam, which is equivalent to the system shown here. So this is system 1. And system 2, which we have to determine, is sketched here. And under system 2, we have a force coupled system acting at point A. That is, we have a force F and a couple of moment MA. We have to determine the magnitude and direction of this force and the moment of this couple. So the first condition is that vectorial sum of all the forces under system 1 is equal to the force F acting at point A. Now, this is a vector equation and it can be broken up into scalar equations. Since the forces are in XY plane, the sum of the X component of the forces under the two systems would be the same. And similarly, the sum of y component of the forces under the two systems would also be the same. So now let us find out the sum of forces in the x direction in system 1, and that is equal to, we just have one force in x direction, and that is 100 newton, and therefore Fx is equal to 100 newton in positive x direction. And we can erase this force to avoid any confusion. And we show the x component of the force Fx in the diagram like this. Now, sum of the y component of the forces in system 1 is equal to, we have three forces in the y direction, 100 newton and 200 newton in positive y direction and 400 in negative y direction. So our equation will be 100 plus 200 minus 400. This will work out to minus 100 newton. And therefore, Fy, which is the sum of forces in y direction under system 2, would be 100 newton pointing in downward direction. So we'll represent this result in the diagram like this. So this is Fy and is equal to 100 newton. So now we have the x and y components of the force which we can combine, and show it like this. This is the force acting at point A, making an angle theta. So we have to determine the magnitude of this force from the two components, Fx and Fy, and also determine the direction of the force. So F would be equal to under root Fx squared plus Fy squared. This will work out to 141.4 Newton. And theta would be equal to tan inverse Fy over Fx, and both are 100. So it will be 100 over 100 and is equal to tan inverse 1, and that would work out to 45 degrees. So theta is equal to 45 degrees and F is equal to 141.4 newtons. So we have been able to compute the force and its direction. We now have to compute the moment of this couple, and we shall do so in the next slide. This is our system 2. And this is the original system, which we are calling as system 1. We have to replace all the forces and the couple by a force couple acting at point A. We have been able to compute the force, which is 141.4 Newton. We have yet to determine the moment of this couple, MA. Now we have the second condition, which is sum of moments about point A under system 1 is equal to sum of moments about the same point A under system 2. And this is nothing but the MA that we have shown here. Now, sum of moments about point A in system 1 is equal to, we'll first decide about the sign convention. Anti-clockwise rotation will regard as positive. And now let us determine the moments of all the forces about point A. You notice here that this 100 Newton force and 100 Newton force in y direction, both are acting at A, therefore will cause zero moment about point A. The force of 200 Newton acting at point C would have anti-clockwise moment about point A, and the moment arm would be 2.5 meters. So this will be 200 times 2.5. The 400 Newton force would have clockwise moment, and its moment arm would be the distance AB, which is 5 meters. And because it is clockwise, we'll have to put a negative sign, 400 times 5. And the couple of 1900 Newton meter will be shifted as it is to point A. So, plus 1900, and this would mean 500 minus 2000 plus 1900, and this will work out to 400 Newton meter in anti-clockwise direction. So this couple is of 400 Newton meter in anti-clockwise direction. And so these two systems are equivalent. That is, they have the same effect on the beam AB. And we can represent this result and the force in a diagram like this, where we show a force of 141.4 Newton making an angle 45 degrees, with the x-axis and a couple of 400 Newton meter in anti-clockwise direction. So that's it. So thank you for watching and see you in the next video.